Okay, today we're going to test the new Subaru Forester. Now, before you laugh at the fact that we're testing a Subaru Forester as a 4x4, let me ask you, how do you use your daily driver most of the time? And would you not appreciate something that works on the highway better? Hey, retain your off-road vehicle, but have something that works good. Well, how good does it work for the daily transportation, yet retains enough four-wheel drive to go off-road exploring? Well, let's find out.
The Subaru family of four-wheel drives has been a yuppie four-wheeler of choice for years. And not because they offer go-anywhere, stump-pulling, rock-crawling capabilities, because they don't. What they do offer is all the practicality you need in a small station wagon with proven reliability and the all-weather traction of four-wheel drive. Now, looked at in the right perspective, that's not necessarily a bad thing. Not bad at all, even for us four-wheeler. For instance, the Forester has a base price of just under $23,000. Our test vehicle, the more optioned S model, had a list of $24,420. For a new four-wheeler in today's world, that's not bad. The base L model comes equipped with air conditioning, cruise control, tilt wheel, an 80-watt AM/FM stereo cassette, dual airbags, fog lights, power outside mirrors, intermittent wipers, and ABS braking, all a standard. Now, the S model adds heated front seats, an in-dash 6 CD changer, keyless entry, 16-inch alloy wheels, and a viscous limited slip rear differential. Suddenly, that price looks even better. Now, plus, the Forester is rated to get 21 miles per gallon around town and 27 out on the open road. Considerably better than most off-roaders are used to, I'm sure. And this is without the cost of anemic performance, as the little 2.5-liter flat 4 puts out a very respectable 165 horsepower. And when coupled to the 5-speed manual transmission, the little Subaru moves along quite well. Now, one really unique feature on the Forester is that the four-wheel drive system is specific to the transmission choice. The 5-speed, like our test vehicle, uses a continuous four-wheel drive system that uses a viscous coupling center differential built right into the transmission case. Now, this unit divides power between the front and rear differentials depending on wheel slip. When the front wheels slip, more power is added to the rear. When the rear slip is detected, more power is added to the front. But the automatic transmission models use an electronically managed variable transfer clutch located in the tail shaft of the transaxle. Now, this system uses sensors to detect the weight transfer during acceleration and braking, sending more power to the rear during acceleration and more power to the front during braking. I guess that sounds good, and while we only tested the 5-speed model, it all seemed to work well on the highway. Well, when four-wheel drive wasn't really needed anyways, I suppose. But once off-road, the drive system, coupled with a lack of suspension flex, severely limited where the Forester could go. Yeah, let's keep it in perspective. The Subaru was really intended for snow use on those northeastern winter roads. But as an SUV that would be used exploring back roads, the all-wheel drive system is barely better than a good, high-clearance two-wheel drive. And a two-wheel drive with a rear locker would simply walk away from the Subaru and the rough stuff. So, what's the bottom line here? The good? Incredible reliability, low price, great mileage, good performance, and lots of room for a little car. The bad? Ineffective four-wheel drive system for backcountry travel, and heel holder brakes that sound better than they work. Bottom line, a reliable little car that with the automatic transmission would be a great little family station wagon. But don't confuse this with a real SUV, or maybe we should say a real off-roader.